workers.
Now. What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want?
Now.
All right. Okay. How y'all doing? My name is Anthony Stewart. I want black workers now.
Sorry, hold on.
Group us, come. Let's form a tighter group, everybody.
Everybody come close together.
There you go.
Oh, park, but it's across the way, and these dogs seem to be blocked. Some people are over there.
All right,
yeah, I support you 100%.
Thank you. We appreciate that.
God bless you.
Thank you. Let me know when you're ready.
Black workers matter. 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 Black workers matter.
How y'all doing? I'd like to thank everybody for coming out, supporting us for these issues and this cause. My name is Anthony Stewart, and I'm with Black Workers Matter. Thank everybody for being here, and God bless us for this day and for us to have a chance to be here. I want to talk about some key facts. One of the key facts is about black unemployment. 37% of the black workers in Chicago earn low wages, under $12 or less.
That's not right.
It's not. It's injustice. Black unemployment has an average of 12%, and that's for the last 50 years. Despite the fact that the black college graduation rate has increased fourfold since 1970. Mm-hmm. And you want to find out the facts of this, go to hashtag Black Workers Matters. The study was done in 2015. 47% of black men in Chicago, average from 20 to 24, has no job and is not in school. This is thanks for a UIC study in 2016. Okay, we need to address this. We need to do something about this. Because if it keeps going on, in my opinion, where there's a high rate of unemployment and no work, there's a high crime rate.
That's true.
So if you want to help change some things, let's start right now. Okay, now I'd like to talk to y'all personally about some things that happened to me. When I was working with Ferrara, the candy company, through Elite, the staffing company. When I was there, I worked hard. I worked there for 3 months. I averaged something like 500 hours in within 6 weeks' time, more than 500 hours. I was a forklift driver. I started off dumping candy, packing skids. When they found out I had skids to drive forklift, they hurry up and put me on the forklift. I passed the physical test with 100. I have no background, no criminal records, no felonies. But yet it's still hard for me to find permanent work. And I was there working 12 hours a day, 6 to 7 days per week, averaging 70 hours to 84 hours a week. I was showing up on time, doing my work as they asked me to do it, when they want, how I want. But when it came time for getting paid, my check was short. My check was weak. I mean, it didn't have the hours, it wasn't accurate. And when I started complaining about it, they kept telling me, oh, we're gonna straighten that out. As the week went by, I noticed that other employees had the same problem. Their check was short, missing hours, and they didn't want us to prove that we was there. And we communicate by text message and saying that we're gonna show up, so I have proof that I was there, but yet I didn't get paid. It took them 3 days to pay me for 1 week. Now, I gave them my heart, I gave them my work, my time, my labor. I missed time with family and friends just to put these hours in, but yet I wasn't treated fair. When I tried to talk to them about it, I got stonewalled. When I asked them what they corrected, they didn't. All I did was got laid off, and they told me there was no more work available, which is not true. There's still work available. You can work up there for up to a year to 2 years, but yet there's no work available. No, it's not good. It's not good at all. So again, when I asked them to help to correct the issue, it got worse. They even cheated me out of hours to the fact that I would qualify for holiday pay, but since they cheated me out 11 hours for that, I didn't could even get holiday pay. So as it kept going on, I kept complaining, hoping, believing, praying that it'd get better with them. It didn't. I continued to work there because I need money. I need to earn money to pay for my bills, to pay for what everybody needs to do. Everybody needs to work. So I endured it for a while. And they kept on messing my check. Every check was messed up since I've been there, starting from the first week to the last. So when I finally complained, started organizing, talking about it, speaking up on it, the result was they let me go. That's how they responded. Instead of doing something about it, they let me go. I'm holding Ferrara accountable because they don't want to hire elite. They give them the power to do what they do, to mistreat people, to discriminate against us, to not even hire us for what we do. We buy candy from them. Candies is in the community. We live in the community, but they're not supporting the community. You know, so this is something that needs to be addressed. And I'm going to tell you right now, we are not slaves, but we are respectable people, and they shouldn't treat us like slaves. They shouldn't put their unfairness, or should I say injustice, on us like this. So what we're going to do, we're not going to take it. We're going to demand equal rights. We're going to demand that they do something about
this.
Because it is not just going to be left unattended to. If you bring this to light, the more people that know about this, the better off it'll be.
That's right.
So, again, they're unfair. They discriminate. They're not paying the wages. And what we want to do is to see that Ferrara take that control out of elite. Take away their power. Do not allow them to have the authority to mess up our check, especially short checks. Do not allow them to continue being the bully that they are, bullying the little man, which is the employees, the workers, the one to make this country work. We want them to see them incorporate, put in a hotline so somebody could call if there is discrimination, if there is injustice, so that way we can respond and treat this accordingly. We want $15 an hour. You can't survive off of minimum wage. You can't survive off of 825 hours. I'm sorry. That is not doing it, and it won't do it. That is unacceptable, and we won't accept it. It's just as simple as that. And we need them to do this immediately, not keep stonewalling us, not keep saying that it's going to get done, but we need it actually done.
Now.
Right, because it's that straight injustice. And we are organizing. We're going to continue to organize. We're going to continue to speak out. And what we're going to do, when this is done, we're going to march in there, give them our demands, as well as our labor charges. For me and this young lady right here, Lisa, Ali, we fall in labor charges because they're not paying us. They discriminate against us. And when we spoke up, they laid us off. So we're going to go in there and demand our rights. We're going to exercise our rights, and we're going to get justice. Because I lost a lot of things when I lost my job. But I didn't lose faith. I didn't lose hope that there's going to be the right thing. And I hope and I'm praying that the right thing will be done. And Ferrara, I lost hope in them. I really did. I actually lost hope. And this is a story, again, like I said, I'd have supported them. I'd have brought their kidney. My kids have brought their kidney. The community's buying their community.
That's right.
But they are not doing anything to help the community.
Behind you.
That's right. And that's what we need, support. And right now, I'd like to take this time to introduce somebody else, Lisa Ali.
Yes. I'm going to give my testimony as to my experience working with Elite, the staffing company, who's also employed by Ferrara. My experience as working with them, I saw where supervisors were denying employees the right to have a break, okay? Right. They denied employees the right to work. When you came in to work, sometimes you were told that we didn't need you, and then you were supposed to be paid the 4 hours for showing up. Sometimes it took weeks before you could get it. I had to track down Elite's corporate and their Midwest office in order to get my hours.
That's
okay, and there was a lot of other employees working there who never got their hours. Okay, I was persistent about it, and that's how I was able to get my hours, but it should have never been that, because if I showed up for work, I should have gotten the hours. They knew I was there.
That's
I had
right.
to sign in. Why did I have to track people down and call people up to do somebody else's job just to get paid? That shouldn't have happened. Not to me, not to any other employees. Not only that, a lot of Ferrara's supervisors pitted black employees against Hispanic employees.
That should have never happened.
That's another form of discrimination. Okay, so the discrimination that was going on within one employee against the next, we're going to sit down and talk to you, never coming about to talk to you, is what brought all of us together. We got to talking to each other about some of the experiences that we had as workers there through the agency, and we're holding Ferrara responsible for all of it.
I am a member of Black Workers Matter.
Yes!
Black,
Black workers matter. And again, to point this out, they are discriminating not against black, just blacks, but Hispanics as well. We all out here struggling. Blacks, right. White, Hispanics, and it's not fair. Lower wages, and the pay is not accurate when you work, and when you complain, you get fired, you get laid off. It's just truly not fair. There's a lot of people who are afraid to speak up from what happened between me and Lisa, because they see that we got laid off. They see that we got fired. They see that we got discrimination. So it's a lot of people. If you talk to Will, if they're not scared, we'll tell the truth. And you can find this out for a fact. Ferrara, it's not being fair. And I'm gonna introduce somebody else that has a testimony they'd like to talk. And it's Abdul.
Good morning, everyone. Woo! Yay! My name is Abdul. I am recently a member of Black Lives Matter. And also, I work for a couple of days at Ferrara here, through RIM staffing. The first day I worked, unfortunately, I was completely ignored, okay, to the point where I wanted to walk back out the door. But I figured, okay, I came about 8 to 10 miles to work for me and my family. I have 2 girls, 8 and 5 years old. Okay, and when I got to Ferrara, I heard one guy tell me, what do you need? I said, I'm here to work. For what? I mean, for what staff? And I said, RIM staff. And he said, okay, go through this gate. It's a gate you go through here. I said, I don't have a car. He said, okay, well, someone to get you a car. I personally waited for about 10 minutes before I went through the gate, you know, to start working. Unfortunately, when they came with a car, I got a little frustrated and I left back out. Okay. I come back the next day, the same process. You got another guy come in, I don't know if it was a supervisor or not, let me in. I missed a half an hour of work. I told RIM staffing about it. They found me some work. But to make the long story short, when I got on the line, going past me, so when I got on the line, I had one guy literally tell me, work. I said, what do you mean work? He said, I want you to work, don't do nothing else. So yeah, I'm stuffing gummy bears in a box, 25 to 35 pounds. The line got a little fast. So I told him, you have someone slow the line down? He said, no, just work. So we pushed the boxes, like intentionally, and not some of the stuff that I was putting in the box, and I pushed it back. I said, I don't think this is appropriate, it's disrespectful, I need to see a supervisor. So one guy, another guy, which I think was the supervisor, told me, he said, you go take a break, go to the washroom or something. So this is what I'm saying, I'm gonna cut it short. It's injustice, I only work for 2 days. Those who've been here for 8 months to a year, you know, what can we do but, you know, try to be out here and promote to secure one another and hoping that things get better.
Black workers matter. Again, I started there as a pelletizer and as a dumpster. I know what he's saying. What they do is to make things quicker. If you're supposed to get an order out by the end of the day, they could speed up the line and they could get out in so many hours and save time to move on to the next project. But the thing of it is, it's wearing off the humans that's working there. We are not robots. We are not machines. And then the attitude that they have, it's like, if you don't do what you say, you gotta go. What it really is presenting a hostile environment, and it's hard for people to work in a hostile environment. If you're constantly being agitated, you're constantly being bullied while you work, you either gotta take it or not take it. This young man, I appreciate him because he didn't take it. A lot of people have to take it, but this man didn't, and I respect that, and I really admire that. Now I'm gonna keep this going, I'm gonna move on to some spoken words. And I'm going to introduce Kia Giles.
We want it now!
What do we want?
Justice! Yes.
When do we want it?
Now!
All right.
Black workers matter. Because you hear me, though? Black workers matter. Because you hear me, though? Brown workers matter. Because you hear me, though? All workers matter. I know you hear me, though. But whose pockets flatter? Who's experienced discrimination to climb up the ladder? Talk about change, but it seems just chatter. If we can all work together, things will be better. But companies, rather, come short on checks, show no respect. 825, who can live off that?
Can't survive.
1 hour pay equivalent to a Big Mac. And I love my Latinos, that's a fact. But Ferrara, why so little blacks? In management, why blacks lack? And what about the turnover? Get on track. Because black workers matters, that's a fact. I'm proud of y'all organizing, no more holding back. Change is needed, now not later. Your candy is sweet, but your equal treatment can be greater. Lemon's head, gummy worms, they sound so great. But do the babies in our communities know about this good candy they ate? If they did it, it wouldn't taste so great. There should be no debate. Change needs to come. But how long is we gonna wait? Power to the black workers matter. I salute you. You strong, encouraged, and y'all great. All right. Woo!
$15 an hour at least.
Yes.
Fight for 15.
Woo.
Fight for 15.
Woo.
Fight for 15.
Yes.
And then after that, make it more. But right now, I want to introduce you to Fight for 15. Let them speak and have a testimony.
Yes. Come on. Hey, Joyce.
Woo.
Fight for 15.
I just want to thank everybody for coming out.
Yes.
It's kind of cold, it's early, I know y'all hungry. But that just goes to show that we got a higher calling and a higher purpose of being about it.
That's right.
We go against our sleep, our hunger, being comfortable and everything else to, you know, get our justice for what we need. But it's not just justice what we need, but it's equality. Because justice is letting us work, but equality is giving us all the same hours.
That's true.
You know? You can work here, but they only give you 1 day. But they get the next man about 3 or 4. That's justice, but it's not equal.
Right.
It's true.
You know? So that's the reason why we're out here. You know, 825, that's you can't live off that.
It's ludicrous.
It's crazy. Yeah, that's slave work. You know? Prices of living is going up. Prices of taxes is going up. Everything's going up. Except for the minimum wage.
You right?
In the city, we got $10. Out here in Oak Park, $8.25. And I'm pretty sure it costs a little bit more to live out here than it do in the city.
It does.
But it makes no sense that y'all getting paid lower than what we getting paid. And I just want to share a little bit of my personal story. Just to let you guys know, my name is Keyshawn Johnson. And I'm with Fight for 15. I work at McDonald's. I've been there for about a year now. And showing since I started, I joined back in 15. Going in, I already knew that it was going to be unjust and unfair working at McDonald's just because it's a fast food chain. You know, they don't care about us. We're grunts. We're not really nothing to them. They say you can come in, and if you don't work, we can just replace you the next day. They don't really care. So, but a little bit of what's going on with me is, you know, I get discriminated against at my job. There's more Hispanics than there is. Don't get me wrong, I love Latino people. I grew up around them like half my life. I love them to death. I know a little bit of Spanish. You know, I feel accomplished. But it's the simple fact of there's more predominant Latinos in my store than there is blacks. And the new manager that came in, he let go of the black people. And for the people that he couldn't let go, he cut their hours down to 1 day. I'm one of those people. I'm one of those people that he cut down to 1 day. And to be honest with you, nobody likes that. Nobody likes getting their hours cut. Nobody likes being discriminated against. Nobody likes being treated unfair. You know, like when you come to work, you're there to get a check and go home. You're there to support people, which is your family and yourself. And they make it hard for us. You know, when you're coming to work and already doing a job that you don't want to do, and then on top of that, they discriminate against you. They taunt you. They disrespect you. And I feel like you should not have to leave your dignity at the door when you punch in.
Right.
So for what you guys going through here for Ferrara Pan, you know, I go through it as well at McDonald's, so don't feel like you're alone. Fight for 15 is here, and we're standing here in solidarity with you. The struggle's real, but the fight is real.
Hold the burgers, hold the fries.
Black workers matter. Black workers matter. Thank you for that testimony.
Thank you. Thank you. And again, 825 an hour, just to give you a little bit of facts, if you make an 825 an hour, that adds up to like $17,160 a year. If you make a 925 an hour, that adds up to something like $19,240 a year. Now, if you do the math on what you spend on your rent, what groceries cost, phone, just cost of living, that is not enough to survive. And again, where you have these low rates where there's no unemployment, you have a high rate of crime, you have a high rate of drug abuse, you have a high rate of everything else that we don't want. So it's just simple math if you look at it. It's just simple.
Poverty.
And there's nothing going on. And discrimination is everywhere. Not just at Ferrara, not just at McDonald's. It's a lot of these places that's discriminated. It's unfair. And they try to pit the black and Hispanics, or even the white, against each other, because some people may want a race riot. But that's not it. I want y'all to remember one thing. There's only one race of people. That's the human race. No matter when it's all said and done, there's only one race of people. That's the human race. No matter what color you are, no matter what language you speak, no matter what God you pray to, there's only one race. So we are all brothers and sisters. So we all should be treated equally. We should all be treated fair. It's as simple as that. Now, again, it is not enough to survive for us. I'm going to emphasize again, fight for 15. Fight for 15. That's just a side to go higher. Fight for 15. Put some food on the table.
Yes.
Instead of Roman noodles. I ain't knocking Roman noodles. Took the crap out of my stomach a lot of time. But put some real food on the table. That's what I'm just trying to say. And stop this racism, this unjust, this everybody's equal. Everybody is human. One race. So don't discriminate.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Stop the personal attacks when people speak out.
That's right.
Stop the unemployment because people spoke out.
That's right.
Stop the unemployment because people had a guts to say what they should have said.
That's right.
That's right.
So again, I'm with Black Workers Matter. I want to recap on something. What we want, what our demands is. We need, again, to call on Ferrara to immediately take control of the payroll out of temporary agencies. We need them to end short checks. We need at least $15 an hour. And we need this for all workers, not just some, for all workers. We need to post a hotline to report discrimination, racism, or any unfair and injustice. We need to stop retaliation against workers for short day rights and to gather and protest. And furthermore, you need to reinstate me, Anthony Stewart.
All right.
At Ferrara.
That's right.
Yeah. Okay.
And at this time, after we're going to go in here, we're going to present the labor board charges to them. We want to speak to the plant manager. We want to talk to them and see what's going to do. And when we get through, we'll meet right back here and I'll let you know the outcome and everything. So right now, we're going to go up in here. We're going inside to give them our demands and to give them our labor board charges against Lisa Ali and Anthony Stewart.
Shut it down.
Shut it down.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
What do we want?
Justice.
When we want it?
Thank everyone for coming out and supporting us. We definitely appreciate it.
Right. We love y'all. Black
not going anywhere. We shall return.
Black workers matter. Black workers matter. Black workers matter.
Be strong.
Black workers matter. 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 Black workers matter.
Black workers matter.
Give me a little paper.
John Costanza.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, boss man. Me and you both, but let's ignore him. That's what I do.
Let's single out somebody to talk to.
Let's go for that.
Or let you pass me. Right. Hello.
Black workers matter. 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 Black workers matter.
Hello?
Black workers matter.
I'm trying to get John Costanza. Can you have him come down to the front desk? Because we need to give him some paperwork. Thank you.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
Don't say shit.
Okay. That's what we're supposed
what
to
do. What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
And we also appreciate John Costanza. Plant manager, please come on down.
15.
Your request, your present is requested. Fight for $15 an hour.
Black works matter.
I can't afford to change my mind with $8.25 an hour.
We can't survive off $8.25.
We need equality and justice. We need the manager to come down.
Please, black workers matter.
From human resources.
Black workers matter. Black workers matter.
Black workers matter.
Everybody, let's shut
black
it down.
Workers matter. No. Black workers matter. Black workers matter. Hello?
Shut it down.
No,
she don't.
She looked
good.
She's hurt, though.
Can't shut it down.
Hello, hello. No, you always give people an opportunity to present what you need. Talk to them, give them a chance to rectify the situation, see if they're going to correct the undoing.
Hello, no, that's the guy that came out.
Yes.
Who kind of love person when Pritchard was big.
Team SSD.
We're asking for John Costanza to come out so that we can give him the complaints that we have and the papers that we filed. And we're waiting for them currently to come out to speak to us.
Black workers matter.
Black workers matter.
Hello, can you smile for me? HR up here, please.
Black workers matter. Black workers matter. Black workers matter. Black workers matter. Black workers matter.
I think they're playing with us.
Black workers matter.
Well, let's walk to the back. We not play with them.
All lives matter.
There's only one race, that's the human race, and we can't survive if we divide. We must unite, especially for injustice.
I took a video. We're all in the same boat.
There's a video of a room on the phone.
We're all in the same boat. Yeah, I can't even move. I wanted to delete the video.
One of your CEOs could come down and speak to us.
I'm plant manager.
Okay, so is one of your managers at this location? Can you come down and talk to us? I have some papers that I'd like to give to them, and we're not leaving until we get a chance to speak to them.
Black workers matter! 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 $15 an hour will make our pockets fatter! Black workers matter!
Black workers matter! Black workers matter!
$15 an hour will make our pockets fatter! Black workers matter!
Black
she workers.
Said if they
want to
come out, then they'll come out, I guess.
Oh,
they ain't coming out. We're
going
to
have
to
no, we're not.
They see
them around the corner, though. Black workers matter. Black workers matter.
Let me see the tape.
Black workers matter.
Yeah,
we're
going to
post this no matter what.
Check, please. Y'all been served. H&R. John Costanza. Anybody with a brain that can communicate.
No, let's just post it.
They ain't stopping, ING, I am not going.
Anybody got some tape?
Yeah, she got some tape. Now we use crazy glue. You know, my fingers got cold out there.
Man, too. Hey, let's give him this.
Black workers matter. Black workers matter. Black workers matter. Black workers matter.
We're gonna put it in. We're gonna leave it in English and Spanish. No. How you doing? John Costanza here? Is that you, sir?
My friends, the police are on their way.
That's okay.
Up here, okay?
That's okay. Not a problem. And you are? And you are?
They.
Your name? No, and you are?
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Y'all can stay here. John work here. And then everybody else, we can walk out.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, not
a problem. Thanks. I'm sorry. I ain't got no wine. I ain't scared of the pop-off.
Black workers matter.
Black workers matter. Black workers matter.
Black workers matter.
That shows you the unjust and the equality they kick us up when they see
raping them. Whose tape is this?
That's, you don't want to deal with
whose tape
my
is this?
ID, my work ID is in my black my bag. You want to grab it for me?
That's okay.
They stand. Everybody got
it. Yeah, okay. All right,
let's take a picture of
it. I stay up here and lay like Carly the mommy. Right. They're going to come out and take you down. Right, right. We got copies of it, though. And we got the media up here. I felt that because they don't want the media out there,
yeah, really,
and they was unprepared for this. They had got a warning, said that we was gonna do what we're doing.
Yeah,
so
somebody will come out.
Sign in. No, I don't think he gave me that.
Black workers matter.
Right, because everybody had to sign in. I'm coming, I'm coming. Thank you, sir.
All right, let's go. Thank you, sir. We appreciate this. All right, thank you. Let's go. We're going this way, y'all.
We thank y'all for coming out, even the officers.
Let's go.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's move before we end up on Black Lives Matter.
There you go.
Come on, y'all, stand up and shoot. Nobody got no guns, but we got the black colors.
No justice! No peace!
No justice! No peace!
No justice!
No peace!
No justice!
No peace!
No justice! No peace!
No justice!
No peace!
No justice! No peace!
Is this far enough off a,
We can just keep, we can be on this, we can't be on that side. All right,
not a problem.
Not a problem.
Not a problem.
It's hard, isn't it?
I appreciate everybody showing up. We went in.
Right, I know. Right.
We're going to do our thing. We're going to do our thing.
I don't see where people are
going. I appreciate everybody showing up and supporting us. It's really been great. We went in there, tried to present our demands and the charges. They hid behind the walls, the glasses, the law. They was afraid. So that means something is going on. That means they're scared. They're scared for a reason. Because they know this is unfair. They know this is unjust. They know what they're doing is wrong. So they don't even want to come out and face the music. But we're not going to stop dancing. We're not going to stop singing. We're going to keep playing this beat. We're going to keep playing this song. We're going to keep doing this until they respond and give us what we want. We're not going away easy. That's like they making it easy for them to get their pockets fat, make it easy for the average man to get their pockets fat. All we want is equality, justice, and what's fair. And that's for every human being that's standing out here. Again, there's only one race, the human race. Right. So we should all work, live, and love, and live together.
Cut it out.
Right, there you go. Cut us in or cut it out. And again, I'd like to thank everybody for this. I like to see all of this support continue, and I like to see everybody keep doing what they're doing. The list, so I can thank everybody. I know I'm going to thank Fight for 15.
Yeah.
You know, we fighting with you, brother.
Stand in solidarity.
Democratic Social of America, we're thanking you for coming out and supporting us.
Green Party. Again, Fight for 15.
Occupy, we are the 99%.
Okay, Occupy.
Yes.
Thank you guys for all your support and coming out and helping us.
I apologize for not having been on as accurate as I should be with this list. Thank you to everybody. And I apologize for that. Next time I'll be better.
It's okay.
Everybody that's here who got a cause, y'all all here for the same reason, common goal. We want justice, equality. We want everything for everybody that we're supposed to get.
And we want it without discrimination.
That's right.
And when do we want it?
Now!
We want it with respect.
Right. Now. And look around us. We all race, all colors, all for one cause. And that's what we got to keep in mind. There's only one cause, injustice, unfairness. Again, I thank everybody for showing up.
All right.